Hello, everybody. Ian Robson here, and welcome to the edition of The New Bear Farm. All right, what is going on today? As you can see, we have our John Deere. I picked up this trailer not too long ago, just because I wanted to use the overloader function of it. And just curious as to whether this is going to work or not, so we're going to give it a quick little go here. So let me just fire this guy up. Ooh, that's a bit loud. Let's turn it down a little bit. There we go. So we're going to try this and see how it works. I'm not 100% sure how it's going to work, but it'll be interesting to see if it does or not. So what we're gonna do is, we're gonna use this tractor as a way to actually overload our manure into a manure spreader. We're gonna see if we can get this to work or not. I'm not sure whether or not we can get it to work or not yet, but I think it'll be interesting to give it a go. And that's mainly because if we can spread manure down, we will actually increase our yield and quite a bit, hopefully. So we don't have to spray fertilizer so many times. All we'll have to do is we'll have to just use this. But I don't know if it's going to work or not. Let me just keep that in mind. And there's a particular reason why I'm not sure whether it's going to work, and that's because it's not a typical manure transport trailer. So it may work. If it does, hey, that's going to be awesome. If it doesn't, okay, that's fine too. So we will see. And unfortunately, just the way the area of the garden center is organized or set laid out, let's say, doesn't make it easy to just drive a course in there, so it may have to be a bit finicky. So we'll see if this works. If it does, great. If it doesn't, that's fine too. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and just drive this back to our main field, or back to an area close to our main field, let's say that. And then what we'll do is we'll use this as an overloader into a manure spreader. We're gonna try at least. We do have a couple options. One thing we need to be careful about is a lot of the manure spreaders need a little bit of horsepower, and some horsepower we don't actually have for some of them. Not all of them, for some of them. So that's the one thing we'll need to pay attention to. I wish this went a little bit faster. This is where a JCB would be nice, then I can just cruise along here at a much quicker speed, but whatever. Alright, so let's see if we can get this done. I'm kind of curious about this, actually. I'm not sure whether this is going to work the way I want it to or not. If it does, that'll be great. If it doesn't, well, that's fine too, I suppose. It's to be expected, I suppose. Because this is such a random course I'm trying out, or a random thing I'm trying out, I don't know how it's going to work, actually. So, went back to the in-laws farm on the long weekend there to help out. Yeah, we were planting potatoes. By the time this goes live, I don't know. We'll see. It'll probably be past that, but I may have put a video up already. But if I haven't put a video up about planting potatoes up until now, well, leave a comment and I'll put a video up of that. Because I snapped a few quick little videos of it, and it should be pretty cool, actually. So let's just go past the fuel, just in case I forget another way around. I don't know, it'd be kind of interesting to see. It was really interesting to see how they had it set up this year. Because this is the first year they had, like, an actual planter for, let's say, a manufacturer. I don't even say this. It's a planter that's made for planting for potatoes and not kind of something to put something that's put together. So it's a bit more modern, I guess, is the best way to put it. Because they used to plant potatoes in a much different fashion, and now they moved to like an actual planter, like the grimy ones they have in game here. So it was pretty cool to see how it all worked together, and I was able to ride along and see how that got planted and stuff. It was pretty neat, actually. Something I have never seen before, because I'm not normally around for when they plant potatoes. Normally I'm around for harvesting, but not necessarily planting, so it was definitely cool to check it out. Alright, so we're coming up on the farm here, finally, and what we'll do is we'll put a little weight point, I think, I want to say in the middle somewhere of these two fields, just because that seems like a good place for it. So let's put a waypoint there. And let's just slow down here for a second. There we go. And let's actually rent a manure spreader. The Ursus one needs 150 horsepower. And this one needs 70. So let's go ahead and rent this for an hour. Let's go 3 hours, because I don't know how long this is going to take. I actually bought this trailer, so I'm not too worried about the trailer. So let's reset that. And let's hop into this guy right here. And we'll detach that for the time being. And our... there's our Ursus right there. And what we'll... I don't normally try... usually with maneuver overloader mode, with course play, usually it works best if it's, really? Oh, I guess we missed that. Usually it works best if it's with slurry, but I don't know see why it wouldn't work with actual manure as well, so it should be kind of interesting. Let's see here. We are going to be in fertilizer mode, I guess it would be. And this will be 10 meters wide. We'll leave it at 10, and we'll try with field 7 first, and northwest corner heading east, and we'll do, let's say, one headland after the fact. Alright, so let's come in here, and let's just overload into this right here. Should just overload straight into it. Perfect. So, the idea is going to be that, where that weight point is back there, that's where the actual loading point will be. But we'll see if we can get it to work properly. So this thing holds... I don't know if that's realistic or not, but it works that way in this game, so... it'd be cool if it actually did, but I don't think so. Alright. I rarely use manure spreaders. Alright, so... let's get this guy. Oops, that's totally the wrong course. We'll start with field 9. There, yeah, that makes sense. I was like, why is he way over there? Alright, let's see if we get this. Let's see how this works. So there's the first waypoint right there. We'll turn these off. We don't need to see these. Ooh, look at that. But you see how much manure we're using already. Excellent. So let's go back to this guy. And we'll just do a little turn around here. Like so. Come into here. Make it nice and obvious. There we go. Perfect. And then we'll go back and see if we can't get it to work the way we want it to. It may not. I have a sneaky suspicion it won't, but at least I won't have to drive the whole way back there again, because it's a long drive. And I think what I might have to do is use a different tractor for that, because this one is awfully slow in comparison. Because if I can get a faster tractor to do this, it would be best. I don't think I could... I don't think I can hook it up to hooking up to the VW bug would just be a little weird as well. Although it might be able to hook up to it. This trailer, I don't know. It would be pretty funny to see. But I think it's a little overkill, so. Or not overkill, but a little odd, so I won't do it. Anyways, I hope everybody had a good Victoria Day long weekend in Canada. I know there are some provinces that don't celebrate it, but the majority of them do, so. I hope everyone had a good weekend. I did. Did a little bit of traveling. Went down to the in-laws' farm there, like I said. And planted some potatoes. Helped out in the farmer's market there as well. Good times. It's so strange when you're not used to dealing with the public with money and all that jazz. And, like, it's very strange. Mainly because it's not something I do in my normal job, so it's very... It's out of my character, I guess. Out of my comfort zone to a certain extent. But the more you do it, the easier it gets. But it is interesting to see how people react to the goods that you have, sort of thing. So it's like, some people are like, oh, is that organic? And they ask all those types of questions. And sometimes you gotta be like, you know, like, do you have any idea what it's like to get an organic certification? And a lot of people don't, which is to be expected, I suppose. Because how many people do you know about that? Like, it's very rare that you would actually have somebody who knows much about it. But some people do, right? One sec, coffee break. Some people actually do know about it, but they are few and far between, is the expression in English. I don't know why I said that, because everyone probably speaks English, but actually that's not true. I know a lot of people, some people speak Dutch. It needs to be refilled. Already? Okay. This is what I was talking about being a long drive. So going an extra 20 kilometers an hour here would be awfully nice. Yep. I could rent a tractor for this, actually. Maybe I'll have to do that. Just for an hour or 2 hours, I don't know, we'll see. Because the problem is I have to go all the way down to, like, the bottom of the map. Like, way down the bottom. And I don't think I have any tractors that would even be remotely fast enough. Like, if I use the Kierowitz, it'd be the same problem, basically. I think the Kierowitz is even slower than this one. I don't think we can increase our speed yet. I think 35 is as fast as it goes, yeah. I hear us hoping, like, oh, maybe I just didn't put the cruise control level top. Nope, it's definitely at the highest it can go. This is like a JCB thing right here. Maybe we'll have to. I still haven't made enough money to get a JCB yet. I don't know what our stores are like. Let's take a quick look while we're just cruising. Barley, canola, straw, grass, potatoes. We could sell some barley, but it's not worth very much. We still have a ton of wood chips. Still have some oats and soybeans. We actually have quite a lot more than I anticipated, actually. I don't remember, didn't realize I had that much. Alright, so this is where it gets a little bit tricky, is this little area right here. Because it's kind of, it's not like a, I can't just drive through it. I have to, let's do this. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to drop off this trailer. And I'm going to turn here. Up here. And then that should straighten out the trail. Let's go a little bit further. Just to be on the safe side. There we go. And that's back up. Now what should happen is it probably will, it's going to back up all the way over to here, and then end the course. And we'll see how that goes. I don't know, let's call this supply manure. And I don't know if this is going to work, but we'll see. At the very least, it'll be a long drive I don't have to do personally, so that will be nice. Now remember, we are buying our manure here. This is not free manure. There we go. So let's just see what happens here. Is that going to be... looks like it should be enough. Alright. Let's see what happens. First waypoint. Oh, we're supposed to stop there. We'll do it this way and see what happens. Actually, that truck might be able to pull that trailer as well. Well, that's the problem with manure. That's how far you get. As you can see, not very far. The other thing we're going to need to take a look at is, of course, the plow situation, because we do have a plow right now. 225. We might be able to get away with using this with our current tractor. Maybe. 2.5 meters. I don't have any other plows. The only other plow I have is this really, really big one right here. And that, unfortunately, is a little bit too big for our current setup. Alright, let's see what happens here. Oh, that's in the way, is it? Let's just push that out of the way. For the time being. I know it's totally unrealistic, but... There we go. And... gonna cruise at the same speed I was cruising at. Alright, so what we'll do is let's go grab our potatoes and top off our actually, what are our cows like? Cows got TMR. They're running a bit low on straw, so let's get a little bit of straw for our cows too. Just while we're over here. And they do have a little bit of manure, 3,500 liters in fact, which is probably not very much. Let's get the straw from here. And that's probably good. They don't really. If they use more than this straw, that's fine. I'm just gonna top this off. And I have a feeling they won't even use this, which would be kind of funny, but. Straw isn't a big part of their diet, let's say that. Perfect, that's that. And let's get the potatoes as well, which is over here. And we'll top off our TMR maker, because at that point we'll be able to... Oh, did I already get all the potatoes? I don't think I did. I thought there was a few left, yeah. Oh, there we go. Alright, and then we'll top off, like I said, we'll top off our TMR mixer, our Rubenschneider, as it's called, and then we'll see how we can get on from there. I'm sure we're still fine for this, but... It's so strange how close you have to get to that thing, it's like crazy close. But it's cool how you can kind of just tip it like this. Alright, perfect. And... I got 75,000 liters still of TMR. Holy smokes. So they're good. They're good. Yeah. Actually, that's a lot more than I thought there was still going to be left. Because you don't really... You have to think about how many days we've progressed it, right? So, like, every time we have a harvest, it progresses 4 days. So, I guess with the number of cows we have right now, it's still not very much, but I guess it's producing quite a bit. Or they're not using very much, I should say. Alright, that's good. And I suspect... Well, he's almost back. Almost. Don't have any cherries yet, so I'll have to wait. That's the biggest problem with the manure. Like, look how little that is so far. And that was full. So 15,000 liters does that, which is the reason why we don't use manure very often. Yeah, I'll have to find a different tractor for that. I don't think I can afford any other tractors that are faster. Let's take a quick little peek. One of these would be nice, maybe. JCB would be ideal, if I'm honest. Because the amount of trucking. Yep. Alright, so our cows are at 110%. This is good. Do we need anything else? Actually, no, we should do. Maybe we'll sell a load of soybeans while we're just chilling out here. And the best place to sell soybeans is... Or we can do wood chips too. Let's take a quick peek. Wood chips, 187, that's a bit down actually. Canola, 433. And where is... This is the problem. I don't know why it doesn't show everything, but often it misses just a little tiny bit. Oops. Where are we? Soybeans. At the bakery. Freight yard. Freight yard it is. So I think we actually have a course set up for that already. Somewhere. And I have a sneaky suspicion. Oh, the John Deere is there. Perfect. And we'll get this guy on soybeans. Sorghum spelt soybeans. And we'll grab this guy. So, the overload, it does, I don't know if, the only problem is I don't know if it's actually going to fold a pipe out. No, it doesn't fold the pipe out. Because it's not, I don't know, because it's not like a typical vehicle to use for this, I think that's the reason why it doesn't stick the pipe out. Unfortunately for us. But we can easily just do this. If I was close enough. Alright. There we go. And the question is, once it goes back, is it going to refill? That will be the real question. But anyways, that's how that course works. Hopefully it works out well. We'll see how that all plays out in the end. Oh, that sound from maneuvers is hilarious. Alright, I'll let that run a little bit and see how it goes. I don't want to show you guys showing this guy going all the way back again, but it'll take a little while, so we'll see how it works. I'll keep an eye on it off camera, but for now, that'll be it, folks. My name's Ian Robson. This has been another episode of Farming Simulator 2015, coming at you from the Noob Farm. Catch you guys later.